Hey there, Michael Church with crawlspaceninja.com, and today I want to talk to you about mold removal in your crawl space. Did you know that 90% of the people who call us think that there's no mold in their crawl space, although they have high humidity and standing water? Then when we go out to do an assessment on the crawl space, we find mold everywhere, to the surprise of the homeowner. Now, this could be because some people don't know how to look for mold, or even if they saw it, they wouldn't know what they're looking for. So I want to give you a little tip on how to look for mold in your crawl space that may not be jumping out at you. For example, you know, if it's not all black and fuzzy and all that, you may not exactly know what you're looking for. Take a really high beam flashlight, like an LED light, along the joist, take the light and put it right up against the joist and shine down the wood. You can do this on the subfloor as well, and you want to shine the light down the wood and put your head right behind the light and look. And what happens is, if you have a little bit of mold getting started, or even something that is kind of a light in color, like a light gray mold or something like that, that's hard to see, it'll show that up really good. It'll give you an opportunity to see if there is something growing on the subfloor. Now, of course, there is no substitution for an actual mold test. So what we recommend also is that you use a mold test in order to identify what type of mold you may have, and also how much, because all crawl spaces and all houses have mold in it. What you want to see is, do you have dangerous molds at high levels? So the only way really to do that is with a mold test. Okay, so if you are concerned about mold in your crawl space and you're not sure if you do have mold or not, a great way to handle this is with our DIY mold test. This is something that we make available on our website. Very easy to use, and you actually send it off to a lab for a full result. So if you're looking to get an inexpensive mold test done, here is a great way to do it, is with a DIY mold test kit. Okay, so what do you do if you find mold in your crawl space? There's a lot of misinformation about this. In fact, there's a video that I recommend you watch, and it's gonna be right here. It's the 5 crawl space repair mistakes that most homeowners and contractors make. And it'll talk about some of the ways to make sure that you're preparing the crawl space for mold remediation. You also don't want to use any kind of bleaches or anything like that. I know that's a very controversial thing. Some people, oh, just throw bleach on it. Well, a few things about bleach. Number one is, it's still not been proven to effectively disinfect mold on porous surfaces. And of course, a porous surface is wood. So the other thing is, bleach is very, very destructive to whatever you put it on, including yourself. I don't know if you've ever been exposed to bleach, but you certainly don't want to be exposed to the fumes of bleach. Another thing you want to make sure of before you start your mold remediation or mold removal project is, you want to make sure that whatever's caused the mold, you have plans to correct fairly quickly. You don't want to go in and remove all the mold, wait a month or two, and whatever caused the mold is going to bring it right back. So if it's high humidity, standing water, a plumbing leak, whatever the case may be, make sure you address that and dry out the crawl space, because the wood can be absorbing all that moisture. So you want to get the moisture level of the wood under probably 15%, maybe even closer to 12%. And you can get a moisture meter, like a surface moisture meter or a probe moisture meter, to check the moisture content of the wood before you get started. A couple of other notes I want to talk to you about is what they call protective equipment, PPE. You want to make sure you have a mask and goggles, and you want maybe a Tyvek suit, depending on if you're sensitive, gloves, and of course safety things like that. You also want to put the crawl space under negative air, and perhaps use what's called a HEPA air scrubber, because once you start attacking that mold, it's going to want to survive, so it'll start to spore. If you spray anything on it or you start rubbing it off, mold has a tendency to want to move to another place, so you certainly don't want it moving up into your house. If you put the crawl space under negative pressure, you can move that mold spore out of the crawl space instead of allowing it to go up inside your home. There's a couple of different options that people choose when they're addressing mold. They'll just spray it with a disinfectant and not remove it, and then they'll also want it removed and disinfected. And then the third option is, they'll want it removed, disinfected, and then a protectant put on to ensure that mold doesn't come back. Keeping humidity low is in fact a protectant, but they actually make some really good compounds to spray on the crawl space to ensure that the mold does not return. And I'll get to those in just a second. But the first thing you want to do is, if you're going to address the mold and remove it, we recommend the Anabec system. That is a wonderful peroxide-based system that attacks the food source of the mold and also disinfects the mold. It can be used for bacteria, viruses, different things, animal damage. If you've got like a raccoon or a possum that got in there and destroyed the crawl space and stunk the place up, it's a really good product for that. Some of the other ways to physically remove the mold would be to use a HEPA vacuum cleaner. Now, these could probably be rented at Home Depot or Lowe's, and if you had a shop vac, you can add a HEPA filter to it. So just using rags and brushes with a good disinfectant is the best way to attack surface molds. And one other thing, just remember that applying or just spraying a disinfectant on mold does not make the mold go away. Here's a few pictures of a house we just did, old farmhouse. The homeowner was not interested in visibly or physically removing the mold. They just wanted us to apply a disinfectant to kill the mold. Okay, the last product I want to tell you about is the Anabec X70, and it is a water intrusion protectant as well as a mold preventative. So it actually stops moisture from penetrating into the wood, kind of like sealing the deck or a stain on your deck does. So it's a really good protectant to keep humidity out of the wood and different things like that. It also uses a silver nanotechnology to kill mold spores. I don't know if you know this, but silver is a natural antifungal. If you want to put a protectant on your crawl space to make sure that the mold doesn't come back, the X70 is what we use. Now, one last thing I do want to say about the X70 product is it's not a substitute for dehumidification. So if you are still high humidity, if you're over 60%, you want to make sure you control that humidity. Okay, well, that's all I had to share with you today. I really appreciate you watching this video, and I hope you'll like the video and share it and subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you next time. Thanks again, and make it a blessed day. Thank you very much.